However, different types of flying monkeys. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about those different types. So on the nasty side, if they're particularly virulent or even narcissists themselves, they'll spread lies, rumours and gossip about you, just the way your narcissist might. They'll reveal secrets or personal information that they shouldn't be in possession of, because your narcissist will have shared it with them. And this is generally information that they have absolutely no right to reveal, but they don't care. They're kind of unconscionable as well. Now, they'll do this on social media or anywhere they can get anyone to listen. Then they'll be nasty and abusive when you meet them, and they'll try to make you feel worthless. And if you've discarded the narc, you'll be painted a complete witch. Now, they're likely to be just as toxic and nasty as your narcissist is. And because they bonded with your narc for whatever reason, maybe they want the status, maybe they just enjoy being nasty for its own sake. But one thing is for sure, they are toxic and you don't want them anywhere near you. You don't want them in your life. Now then we've also got the naive flying monkeys. And these are people who have fallen for the charming facade that most narcissists are so good at putting on. They genuinely think that the narc is a good, nice, decent person. So when he starts spinning his web of lies about you, naive person mops it all up and thinks that you're the crazy one, that you're the one with the problem. I mean, their thinking is, why would such a nice person, like your narc is, lie about you? There must be something wrong with you. Why indeed? If only they knew. But the sad fact is, they don't know, because just as the narcissist was able to dupe you into thinking he or she was a wonderful person, they've done that with all these other people. Now, although these types, the naive types, won't go all out on character assassination of you, they still belong in the enemy camp because you can't trust them. The narc might well, and very often does, use them to find out what you're up to and report back to them, you see? So they're not safe. They're not safe people. So they might, for example, sneakily pump you for information because the narc has convinced or conned them into thinking that they're really concerned about you and they need to know what you're up to and how you're feeling and so on and so forth. So they could actually approach you in a really genuine way because they think that the narc needs this info because he or she is concerned for you. And of course, they're completely oblivious to the reality of covert narcissistic abuse. But why do narcissists do this? Simply, they want fuel and they want to continue hurting, destroying and discrediting you because that gives them the narcissistic supply. And that is what's valuable to them. And that is valuable in any shape or form they can get it. So if you get into a rage and tell the flying monkey to go and take a flying F, that's going to get straight back to the narc and he's going to love it because he's going to get a hit of narcissistic supply from that. So what can you do to protect yourself from these flying monkeys? Well, there are some things you can do and I'm going to give you some quick tips that will help you. So tip number one, no contact. Sever all contact with the narc and with everyone you know who is associated with him. Now, he'll very probably have flying monkeys spying on you, so block the bloody lot of them, okay? Go through your friends list on social media and block them all. Keep only friends that you know you can trust. And set your profile to private and be very, very careful, or rather even suspicious, not to accept any new friend request unless you really know who you're dealing with. If you do get such requests, check with mutual friends Who is this person and why do they want to friend you? Always be thinking in the back of your mind, in fact, keep it at the forefront of your mind, is this one of his or her flying monkeys or potential flying monkeys, okay? And continuing with that theme, tip number two is trust no one. Trust no one but the people you know deep in your heart and soul you can trust. Now, these will be, or should be, people who don't like your narc, or who really believe you and knows that you're not the one to blame, and they won't buy into any of his or her BS. Be wary of any new people who come into your life unexpectedly. You have to be, unfortunately, but it's true, you have to be a bit paranoid and suspicious of anyone you don't know really well, okay? So tip number three, the next thing you can do is warn people. Let the people in your life that you know and trust, let them know what you're dealing with and what the fallout is likely to be from your ex. Now you could or should also do this at work. Let your boss or your colleagues or others know what you're up against in case your ex finds a way to infiltrate your workplace and cause trouble there. And believe me, it happens. Okay, so tip number four, it's again a little bit along the no contact lines, but keep away. Just keep away from places where you might run into your ex or any of his pals. Find new places to go. And if possible, have a trusted friend with you. And tip number five is to ground yourself. Ground yourself in your reality. This is really, really important. You know the truth. You know what is really going on here. So don't get upset or derailed by what the narc is trying to do. Keep your feet firmly planted on the ground and don't give in to the fear, rumination and speculation of what all this might mean. Okay, so that's five simple quick tips that are effective if you apply them and stick to them, okay? Now, if you're really struggling with this or any other aspect of healing from narcissistic abuse, then please reach out to me. I'm helping women every day to completely heal from narcissistic abuse.